I now give the floor to Mr. Alexandre Zouev.
Thank you very much, Madam President. First of all, I would like to thank you for convening this briefing. And today I am especially pleased to be joined by our distinguished police commissioners who are currently serving in UN peace operations in the Central African Republic, Haiti, Mali, and South Sudan. This annual briefing is an opportunity to reaffirm the vital role United Nations police plays across the spectrum of conflict prevention to peacekeeping to peacebuilding. It also serves as a forum to discuss our achievements, as well as what more needs to be done to advance the role of the United Nations police as a service provider and focal point on policing and law enforcement matters. 2.5 years ago, the Secretary General launched the Action for Peacekeeping initiative, calling on all stakeholders to collectively address the challenges facing peacekeeping, which remains an essential multilateral tool for preventing conflict and sustaining peace for millions of vulnerable people around the globe. A4P priorities are overarching. They guide the work of DPO and peacekeeping operations in the field. The implementation of Security Council mandates and our response to the COVID-19 crisis. The United Nations police, as a key component of United Nations peacekeeping, is strongly committed to advancing A4P priorities and to further strengthening the effectiveness of peacekeeping operations. Today, I will speak about the results we are achieving through our ongoing efforts to reinforce peacekeeping. I will also highlight areas in need of greater collective progress and welcome hearing your own plans in support of the A4P agenda. Madam President, as we work to ensure political progress, partnerships with regional and sub-regional organizations, as well as across the UN system, are critical, particularly to facilitate transitions. In Darfur, for example, UNPOL have been working closely with the African Union on the drawdown of UNAMID and transition to UNITAMS, with a view to sustaining peace and preventing a relapse into conflict by ensuring adequate interim policing capacities. UNPOL also play a key role in all aspects of protection of civilians, including physical protection. In the Central African Republic, UNPOL helps foster a protective environment through police capacity building, including by assisting with the recruitment and training of 1,000 gendarmerie and police cadets, with an additional 1,000 cadets forthcoming. UNPOL have also been instrumental in raising awareness about preventing the spread of COVID-19 and have distributed personal protective equipment, hygiene products, and medical supplies throughout our mission settings, particularly in the most vulnerable communities. To ensure the highest levels of performance and accountability, UNPOL, in close cooperation with member states and other partners, have advanced the integrated peacekeeping performance and assessment framework and the comprehensive performance and assessment system, pursuant to which UNPOL have implemented standards to further evaluate the impact of deployed officers and to take actions in case of underperformance. Aligning pre-deployment training by member states with the organizations in mission training is central to enhancing performance. The DPO Police Division, together with our integrated training service, continues progressing the development of standardized training model under the UNPOL Training Architecture Program. In the area of women, peace and security, gender-responsive policing is essential for effective UN and host state policing, and to ensure that the different security needs of men, women, girls, and boys are taken into account. That's why UNPOL is making gender-responsive policing a core priority of its work. In addition, UNPOL has continued to engage with police-contributing countries to surpass the already achieved intermediate gender parity targets for 2020, including at the common levels. Greater women's participation at all levels sends a strong message to host populations, which is amplified when those women occupy positions of leadership and authority. I am pleased that currently three of our police components are headed by women commissioners. UNPOL have continued to reinforce zero tolerance for sexual exploitation and abuse, including through pre-deployment and in-mission training. Conduct also relates to how we manage the environmental footprint of our missions, and UNPOL have refined their environmental management framework by aligning initiatives of police components in MINUSCA, MINUSMA, MONUSCA, and UNAMID with their missions, environmental risk management plans. Climate and security, the devastating consequences of which have been laid bare by COVID-19, is a growing threat multiplier for our missions and host communities. I expect this, in line with the achievement of all the sustainable development goals, to become a larger focus of UN policing going forward. Madam President, A4P aims to refocus peacekeeping on realistic expectations, make peacekeeping missions stronger and safer, and mobilize greater support for political solutions, for well-equipped, well-trained forces. Through A4P, we are better able to address today's challenges to peace and security and ultimately improve the lives of those we serve. I thank all of you for your continued dedication to implementing your respective A4P commitments. Finally, Madam President, we are grateful for the Security Council's commitment to support our efforts and hope we can continue to count on it. Thank you very much.